Time to earn some money. Okay, maybe later on, time to participate in the parachain auction and get some free nodal coins. This video is going to be about that, so stay tuned and let's do it. Hello everyone, my name is Andrew and today we are going to contribute to the nodal crowd loan and participate in nodal parachain. So I will show you in this video how to participate from the zero. I mean, if you don't have anything and you just want to participate and you don't know how to do it, how to start it. Wow, it's so like a forest for me. I don't know anything. Calm down. Everything is okay. Everything is under control. This is going to be step-by-step video on how to participate in this nodal crown loan Polkadot parachain. Of course, if you haven't seen, please check my other video about the thoughts about the nodal application project itself. I will leave the link in the description. And now let's jump to the nodal website and let's try to participate in this parachain. To start with, you have to go to parachainnodal.com website. First of all, of course, you have to connect a Polkadot wallet to this website and you will need a separate login for your browser. Once you press on connect to Polkadot wallet, you'll get the information that you need to download the Polkadot extension and follow the steps here. Okay, and we have two options. One is for Chrome and one is for Firefox. I like Firefox more than Chrome, so I'm gonna do this tutorial with the browser I'm using. So it means Firefox. Press on download for Firefox. We get add on page right away. So let's just press add to the Firefox. Yes, let's add it. Extension was added. Very, very well. Reviews. Everything is more or less fine. I can see 5 stars almost everywhere. So looks like we can trust this extension. So as we can see, browser extension does one thing. It manages accounts and allows the signing of transactions with both accounts. And now we have a new icon in our browser. It's a Polkadot. So let's press on this icon. We have to configure this wallet. So here are some basic information. They just say that they do not collect any information, which is really, really nice. Let's continue. I'm just starting with this wallet. I don't have any new account. So let's press add. We got an address and we have the keys. Next, let's allow to use on any chain. Let's call it Polkadot and we should create a new password for this account. Oh, and by the way, if while creating your wallet, you will press anywhere else on any other window, like here or some other window, it will disappear. You press again, you will get a new key and a new phrase. So be careful about that while doing the setup, because even if you write down the phrase, if you press somewhere on your screen, it will disappear. Of course, if you do everything properly and write the seed on the paper and the password, remember the password, of course, it's better to have a generated password, but still, if you get a password generated and if you type it by hand, everything will be okay. So keep that in mind and don't press anywhere on the screen while configuring your wallet. Let's add the account. Great, looks like account was created. So let's press on connect to the Polkadot account again. We will get a notification asking to authorize. Always read what's written on your screen. These messages might feel like it's not important at all, but they are important. So always read the messages you get, because scammers are all around the world and they're just looking how to get your data, your money and everything else. So please read the messages and always make sure you are on the correct website so you can check on the address bar and it should be with HTTPS. Well, usually, not always, but usually. So always check those things. That's very important. We can see that application Nodal is requesting to access from parachainnodal.com. Yes, Let's give access. You can see my accounts, Polkadot, public key, and at the moment we don't have any dot coins in here. So if you find this useful, of course it's not finished yet, but the referral code, I will leave it in the description, and if you would use my referral code, I would be more than happy, and I would say thank you for doing that. It will not be anything bad for you of doing that, and I would get a little bit of profits from the auction you are using in. So kudos if you use my referral code, because I'm not getting anything for this stuff I'm doing here. So yeah, at least a little bit of money would be really, really nice. To get some coins, in this case Polkadot coins, to our newly created wallet, we need to get it from some kind of exchange or your other wallet. So in this case, I'm gonna transfer my funds from the exchange. And the exchange I'm using is Kraken. To get your wallet address, you have to go to polkadot.js.org website first and press on apps wallet hosted. So press on that link and you'll be redirected to apps explorer page. First, of course, you'll need to connect with your newly installed wallet on your browser. And as you can see, it looks a little bit pink. And this is the basic information about your account. Now press on the accounts and you will see your Polkadot extension added. Now what I really recommend before doing anything else is to export your wallet. So press on the Polkadot icon, you will see your extension, press three dots and export your account. Type your password and press I want to export this account, and then save it on your hard disk and preferably somewhere else on external USB stick. Why I recommend this? Well, in case you would lose it or something bad would happen, so you would have a copy of your extension, not wallet, but that extension. Now, if you want to get your wallet, you have to press on the picture on the icon near the Polkadot extension name, and your Polkadot wallet address will be copied to the clipboard. I'm using Kraken Exchange, so I'm gonna add a new withdrawal address. So let's call it something simple like Polkadot Parachain, and let's paste this new address I have just got. Add withdrawal address. I would need to go to my mailbox and approve that I am adding this address. In your exchange, it might be different. The approval process might be different than in the Kraken exchange. As in the Kraken exchange, I have to approve all withdrawal address, which is very, very good. If somebody else would try to add a new withdrawal address to get my money from the exchange, I would get a notification in my email. So I think there should be something similar on other exchanges, but this function of Kraken exchange, I really like it. I really appreciate it. So once the address is approved, once you press on the email you got, let's go again to the exchange and let's try to transfer the funds, the Polkadot coins. I'm back to Kraken Exchange. I did a test transaction. As you can see, one dot was transferred before, which I really recommend you as well. If you're doing anything for the first time, do it first with a small amount, like I did just before, just a couple seconds ago, with one Polkadot, to make sure everything is fine and my coins will go where they supposed to go. And now we have 14 Polkadot coins left. So I'm gonna transfer all of them 100% and let's press withdraw. Always use double authentication, password or anything like that. In this case, I'm using and Google Authenticator. Always do two-factor authentication everywhere where it's possible. You'll get less chances to get hacked. It's still possible, but more difficult. So a minute or two has passed and we have great news. Let's go to the app and we can see that we have 15 Polkadot coins in here. Let's go back to the Nodal page. Okay, let's connect to Polkadot wallet. You don't have any referral code, unfortunately. Confirm that you are not from these countries and press continue, we get a new notification asking to confirm this, and contribution was successful. 15.6 dots were contributed. Estimated project rewards, 312 nodal coins. So this looks quite an easy task, just if you know what to do. On this website, on Nodal website, it's really easy, but to connect the wallet, it was not so easy as I expected. As you can see, everything is darker in here. Why? Because it's already dark where I live. So basically, it took me like 2 or 3 hours to figure everything out and do this short, I hope it's gonna be short video. So if you find this useful, I will leave a referral link in the description of the video. Please use it. Some coins will get back to me and that will cost nothing, totally nothing to you. And I'll be really, really grateful for that. So I hope this was useful. Please let me know your thoughts if you're going to contribute and how many dots you are going to contribute. Okay, Polkadot coins you are going to contribute. What do you think, what will happen to this, what the price will be of the Polkadot coins after 2 years, once you get them back? Will it be bigger? Will it be smaller? Nobody knows, but I hope it will be bigger. It's $25 now, so there is plenty of room to go up. So I hope it will be bigger. So please leave your thoughts, how many Polkadot coins you staked, or maybe you did not stake at all. And thank you for watching. See you next time. Cheers. I'm doing it for the first time and no. Stop. It's taking too long, definitely too long, longer than I expected. Finito. At last, I finished. It took hell along longer than I expected.